Good morning, guys. It's almost 8 o'clock here in Germany. What could be a better time to record a YouTube video? So, yeah. Maybe there are better times, but anyway, what I want to do today is to show you how you can increase the spotting capabilities of yourself in IL2 with tweaking the game. So, you must notice that the standard values, or the standard setting IL2 comes with, is bad. So the spotting in the standard settings is really, really bad. That comes first and foremost because the engine IL2 uses is basically 10 years old. It's the Rise of Light engine. And they copy-pasted the Rise of Light engine from 2009 and 10 into IL2, put a few shaders on and a little bit more graphical stuff, and also they ported it to DirectX 11 and called it a day. In my opinion, that was a really bad decision, because the closing speeds in Rise of Light, because you fight with biplanes there, was of course much lower. So say, for example, you fly a biplane with 200 kilometers an hour, the enemy flies with 200 kilometers an hour directly to you, you have a lot more time to spot him. Even if the spotting itself was bad, but you had more time to do it. And in IL2, the closing speeds are sometimes 500 kilometers per hour, or even faster when you dive. So that's really, really bad. So what I want to do right now is to show you first how IL2 looks with the standard settings, with a custom mission, and then I will show you my tweaked graphics settings, and then we compare the two. So because really, when you install this game and want to spot, mostly you will have difficulties. I'm not the only one saying this. Ape of the Year made a video about this a long time ago. I think it was in 2015. There are forum threads going on about this. Also, other guys who fly the game, for example, Karaya, he was saying that he has having difficulties with spotting in this game. And so it's when you sometimes can't see something, maybe it was your fault, but maybe really not. It's absolutely possible that the engine screwed up. For example, let me show you a video right now on YouTube with an error or with a game bug where you can't see enemies against clouds. So, here we are at this scene. The video is by Geramos. You can have a look on YouTube, and he's in a battle, and I want you to pay attention to the right side. I will show you this a few times so you can see it, because of course a YouTube video can be a little bit it doesn't have the best quality, but you can see what I mean. So pay attention to his right side. I will click play, and here are planes. Here is one, and here one just disappeared in the cloud, or in front of the cloud. He's not in the cloud, he's in front of a cloud. You see this? Now he's there again. He's here. And he disappeared in front of a cloud again, and he dives further, and he will appear again in the sky. See this? One more time. Jump a little bit backwards. Nothing there. Plane appeared. Plane disappeared. Plane reappeared. And guess what? I think there is a third plane as well. Yeah, see there he is. One more time, so you can really see it, what I mean. So this guy is clearly visible against the sky. He is about, I don't know, maybe 2 kilometers away. Not even, maybe one, I don't know. And the two planes right here are in front not behind or within, but in front of clouds and are completely hidden. It was shortly visible here. Here it's not visible again because he's against the cloud. He disappeared again. He reappeared. And magically, the third plane appeared. That is bullshit. Imagine if that were enemies and you were fighting him or them. Or these all three were enemies and you were would be fighting them. That's absolutely ridiculous. I can tell you right now that this is engine related. You can't change this. What I will show you is how you can increase the contrast and the gamma and the colorfulness of the game so you can spot visible or in theory visible planes better. But this stuff right here is engine related, and that's why I was thinking and that's why I was telling you that going with the old Rise of Light engine was, in my opinion, a big mistake. You can't get rid of this. The developers know about this. They said we have what we have, and that's what we have, and we can't change this right now. They know about this problem, but it's not. Yeah, we can't do anything about this. That can be a game breaker. So, you can't get rid of this, but you can't get rid of other problems. So let's jump right in. Okay, so now we are in the game, in the quick mission screen. I will set up a flight of allies and enemies, and I will set them to a different altitude. So we start at 3000, they start at, let's say, 1000. So that's a typical scenario, right? You are above the enemy and want to spot him. We will set them to a side, so they will be either on the left or on the right side. I don't know. We have to see that. And the distance, let's see, maybe 6 kilometers. Something like that. Yeah. Okay, so I don't want to fight. I don't just want to show you the contact visibility in general. And also the map. Let's say Arpino, let's say Moscow, yeah, okay. Stalingrad, autumn or summer, let's say autumn. So that's a pretty standard map on servers. So Stalingrad, especially on Wings of Liberty, you know, all this area here or the Volga area, right? So that's pretty realistic. So let's see if we can see something. Okay, so now we are in the game. I have enabled the labels, but I think it's a good idea to disable them, actually. Right here. This, of course, is an ally. But right in the middle of the screen. It's really hard to see. I can see the enemy planes as well now. They are above the river. I don't have my mouse pointer. So can you see the river in the bottom of the screen? There you can see very shallow red triangles with distance above them. So one is 4.95, the other is 5.18 kilometers away. I don't know if you can see this in the YouTube video. It's really, really hard to see. To the bottom right here. That is bad. You can easily miss this. Easily. Of course, when you have a eagle eye and zoom in completely. So let's actually do this. So right there. I'm fully zoomed in now. You see that? These two enemy guys. And I lost our ally, who was above them. I completely lost him now. They are over the forest now. And coming closer. 3.5 kilometers. There you can start to really see him. 3 kilometers now. Now you would be able to see him. And the other guy is... Oh, look at me. There he is on my six. How did he get there? I didn't see him crossing this path to my six. And even right now, this situation, disable the labels. You see that? He's 1 point something kilometers away. Enable the labels again. 1.38 kilometers. That's nothing, right? He's about to shoot, basically. He's closing in fast. Would you have been able to see him in this situation? I don't think so. He's just two darker pixels against a pixelated brownish background. When you zoom in, yes, sure. But right now, would you be able to spot him? Maybe. But the chance is actually low against this ground. He's still closing in. And that's what I mean. In the standard settings, we have really eagle eyes. And when you are fully zoomed out and maybe focusing on those two, they are dogfighting right there. Right? So you have a look at these guys. You have a look around. You see, oh, okay, skies are clear. Okay, yeah, okay. You focus on these guys again. Would I go in now? Would I attack one of these two? And now you think, oh shit, I have a six. And then you would start to maneuver. And because now he's against the sky, right? But you would not see him approach against this brown poop color background. So now I want to show you how you can increase this. You can't fully get rid of it, of this bad situation, as I told you earlier, but you can, yeah, you can make it a little bit better. So what you need to do is as follows. Okay, so what you need to do first is you go to your game folder, IL2, for me it's Battle of Moscow, but for you it's maybe named differently. Then you go to the data folder, and in that folder you find a file called startup.cfg. You open that file with Notepad, and in that you find all the graphics options that you can set in the menu as well, but we will set them here. Because the gamma slider in the game only goes down to 0.8, but we will actually go ahead and set this to 0.5 and save the file. What that does is it increases basically the contrast of black dots against whatever, so you can see them better. That is a really good option. Ape of the Year showed this trick as well, and it still works in 2018 or 19. Ha, excuse me, I'm not used to the new year. So it's useful still. And right now we will jump into the game. Oh no, actually not. What I want to show you first is this here. So what you are going to do now after that is you go to reshade.me and you download this file right here. It's just one file. And you launch this. It's really easy, so I'm not gonna show you this. So you launch the file, and you point it to your executable of IL2, not the launcher, but the game itself, IL2.exe, I think it's called. Yeah, bin game, yeah, IL2.exe. And then, now we will jump into the game, and I will show you what you have to set there. Okay, so now we are in the game, and we press the home key, which is the default key to enable reshade in a game. And there I have set colorfulness and clarity. I have showed you this a little bit in the other video, in the last video, but I'm going to show you the actual settings now for the program. So clarity, these are the values if you want to copy that. I think these are the standard values. Maybe I fiddled with them a little bit, but not too much. So that's increasing the clarity. So yeah, can you see the difference in the background? Have a look at this pillar right here, and then I check clarity, and it gets all more clear. That's why it's called clarity. You see the difference? The colors pop a little bit more, and it becomes clearer to see. I don't know what it really does, so I'm not a graphical expert, but to me it looks better. And of course, colorfulness. Colorfulness, for me, I don't use it to really increase colorfulness. It's just so the contrast is better. So have a look at this red star on the plane. Dull red, better red. Dull red, better red. So it increases the colors as well, but also the contrast. So, and that's really my main goal. So what I showed you earlier in the custom mission is that you couldn't see a contact with 1.4 kilometers away, roughly. And that is because there is no contrast between the background and the foreground, which is the enemy plane. And what I wanted to do is to increase that. So right now, let's have a look at the same mission. So that's the setting from before. 3000 meters starting altitude, 1000 meters enemy start altitude, aside and 6 kilometers away. Okay, so we'll stick with it. Okay, now, even over the forest, you can see what's going on here. Let's zoom out, and they're still visible. The guy before was at 1.35, and you couldn't see him against the ground. But now, it's just a little bit better. Not perfect, by any means, not perfect. But you can see this guy is 3 kilometers away. This guy is 1.5 and closing in. And I guess he's about to shoot me, but I don't care because it's just a submission. He wants to pitch up. You see that even against this poop color background, it's really now possible to see what's going on. There's an ally, there's an enemy shooting, another guy passing by, and now we have kind of the same situation as before, where we had an enemy on our six, but we couldn't see him, and he was 1.4 kilometers away. I'm fully zoomed out now, and against the same background, he's still visible. Even when I pause the game, he's clearly visible at 2 kilometers. Compared to other games where you can spot much better, even greater distance, this is still not good. But now you are able to see him. Let's get a little bit lower, so we really have a similar situation as before, where he was right on our six. Stay fully zoomed out. You see this? He is now a blacker dot at a farther distance, and he is better to see. So that's basically my trick here. to increase the contrast. Even that guy right there, he's 4 kilometers away, but you can see that there's something going on. Even if you can't ID what plane it is, but you can still see there's something going on right there. Not clearly, not super clearly, but way better than before. Okay, yeah, so that's my graphic settings I'm flying with. I know the video, again, is a little bit long, but the problem is a big one as well. So, I hope really that I could help you with this, because situational awareness in that kind of simulator is really key to having a good experience. If you constantly have to ask yourself, oh, where did that guy come from? I didn't see him. Even though you checked your 5 seconds ago. That can be a lot of frustration for people. And it was for me. So I tweaked a lot of stuff. So that is basically my result. That's not all I have done. That is my result of all what I have done. I tried other things, but nothing was as effective as this. Okay, guys. So I hope really I could help you with this. Let me know in the comments if it was successful for you. And I wish you a great day, guys. Until the next one. Bye-bye.